I'm working on this little snapper lawnmower, and I took the carb apart to clean it, and it's really bad. And the carb's not on there right now, but it's got the 9-horse Briggs and Stratton, whatever. So I'm taking a gamble, bought the Chinese carb, and we're going to compare them and see if it works. Back at the bench, I have the carb, which I did clean it several times, but the needle and seat are shot, and I really don't want to replace the seat, so if I can, I'm going to put the Chinese carb on there and see, hopefully it works. Anyway, so here's the new carburetor. It came with a fuel valve, these little carb cleaning brushes, the carburetor itself, a fuel filter, oh, it's just rolled off the bench, and the fuel line and the gasket. I got these guys side by side. They seem to be close. As you can see, the fuel inlet's a little different. That shouldn't matter because the fuel line will just flex around. Look at the opening there, opening there, pretty similar. This guy over and this guy over. This is the Walbro. Actually, it's a Walbro 54993 LMT. So, as far as this side, it's close enough. Flip it over again. Is, of course, it's a different design here than here, but it may work. And then here it's adjustable. This Chinese one did come with this cap for the adjustment screw. So I hopefully I'll just bolt it on and it'll work. But if it doesn't, I should have some wiggle room with this adjustment screw. So I'm gonna slap this thing on and see what happens. Got the carb mounted on there. I don't have the air filter or any of that crap on there yet because sometimes these cheapy carburetors will leak out the mouth of the carb. So I just want to see how that is. So far it's not. I haven't tried starting this at all, so I'm going to try right now and see what happens. Choke on. Wow, it actually seems to run pretty good. I can't believe it. It actually runs really good. So as long as this thing doesn't start leaking or anything weird like that, I'll put a link in my description, and hopefully you have the same luck. I'm genuinely shocked because I've had bad experiences with these fakey carburetors. So for now, that's it for this carb video. I didn't want to run it long because this entire crankcase is full of gas. The dipstick's full all the way to the top because the previous carburetor was so bad that the float just stuck and filled it up with gas. So the customer actually didn't want the oil changed because they did it last year, but I'm gonna have to change the oil. So see you on the next video.